Our case today is 27 mgs, 800 grams, admitted due to RDS, received one dose of surfactant. So our senior respiratory therapist, Mr. Abdulaziz, will show us about the ATC automated tube compensation, how to add it, what is the benefit, stand it for what, he will show us that. Our sister Ansu will help us, and Dr. Bakri and Sister Juru also will help us in this issue. Mr. Abdulaziz, please.
So ATC is automatic tube compensation. It's an additional feature in ventilators, like this ventilator, Dräger VN500. This feature, it overcomes the ETT resistance. From here, from ventilation settings, and then we go to additional settings. This is the feature, ATC. You choose on. You put the ATT size, which is 3, and you put the percentage of compensation. Either you want it 180, but the company, they recommend 80% compensation. So now it's on. Now it shows ATC, which is this feature is compensating for the ATT resistance with this mode.
This pressure you make compensation for ET. This is according to what? To the weight, to the age of the baby, or what?
No. It calculates. Huh? It does mathematics and physics. It calculates the ETT resistance, and it gives continuous pressure support to drop this resistance by the ETT.
No, I mean it's like your figure is 80 now, okay? You put 80.
Yes.
You told it is recommended, or according to
80.
What?
80% is recommended by companies.
Because actually, if you put it 100%, the patient cannot feel this ETT. So have at least you say keep 20%, you will feel it.
Okay.
So 80% just to give space for the baby to feel the tube. Otherwise,
yes,
you cannot sense this tube at all.
So I start with 80 for any baby?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
This is recommended. So if you put 100, the ventilator will take all the ATT workload, you know. But it's recommended by companies to put 80%.
So what is the benefit? Just compensation of any resistance in the ATT so that it will
overcome this
one?
Yes.
Then
overcome this resistance,
overcome
so will decrease the work of breath. Yes, and it will help the patient.
So we have to get a precaution if we give the patient surfactant or not the chest after surfactant 2 or 3 hours. Expect that the pressure will drop down. If all what we put ATC, so we can drop down or what? We have to put in mind.
Yes.
Whenever we give surfactant, we're expecting that surfactant will release the pressure. So most probably if all muscle pressure on ATC, we have to guard that maybe it will.
Yes, for sure. If you do surfactant, compliance will improve. You have to sit with the patient and decrease the pressure for that.
Thank you.
Shukran.